everybody. Yes, I'm back. It's your old boy Pie again. Yeah, bars. Well, hey, it's been wild. Me and Cassie been busy moving. Oh, I've missed you all so much. It's been something else. Well, along the way, I've gotten great news for you. Oh, there's a great gaming community now. It's called Ulysses. Make sure you go to Facebook. Check out Ulysses Flight Squadron. Oh my god. Awesome people. Awesome gamers. Family environment. No egos. No, none of that weird stuff. Oh. Whew. I'm out of breath. Just so excited. Oh. Yeah, I'm going to get back to doing my crazy funny things. And also, I'm going to introduce you to a couple people that kept Kenny being Kenny. Right here on YouTube. Oh, I'm so thankful for their videos and the time they put into them. I want to introduce you to two great people, Mr. Ballin and L from TMG, or TMF, TMG, the Matthew Gang. Oh, I'm just so excited. Whew. Well, I tell you what, I'm going to go ahead and show you this video real quick about, you know, different things that L's put out here. Oh my goodness, him and his wife Queen are beautiful people, and a big yappers to them, big yappers to Mr. Ballin. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Let me get you started with getting you introduced. Boy.
A little bit just in case.
We're gonna get to this video and see what type of house of horrors we got here. All
right, we'll so crank that stuff up.
Hit that subscribe button, join the fam, and here we go.
Today, we're gonna look at three places you can't go and people who went there anyways. But before we get into today's stories, if you're a fan of the strange, dark, and mysterious delivered in story format, then you come to the right place because that's all we do and we upload once or twice a week. So if that's of interest to you, please log on to the Like Button's Netflix account and fast forward all of their continue watching shows approximately 2 or 3 minutes. Also, please subscribe to our channel and turn on all notifications so you don't miss any of our weekly uploads. All right, let's get into today's stories. Change. In 2019, Van Buren made international headlines 1950s, Ronald Sear joined the Air Force and fought in the Korean War. And then after he got out of the military, he moved back to his hometown of Van Buren, Maine, and he moved into a very modest two-story home right near town. And for a little while, he just kind of floated about, didn't really have a direction in life. But eventually, because of his love for working with his hands and his general skill at working with his hands and building things, he started a small but successful tool selling company that he ran right out of his shed on his property. Fast forward to 2019, Ronald Sear at that time was 65 years old, and he still lived in the same property right near town in Van Buren. However, he now lived alone. And he still ran this tool selling business right out of his workshop. And for Ronald, this
That's
was
a beautiful house.
He was very content with his life.
It's like everybody's granddad, right? So everybody got a young granddad or uncle or somebody that sounds like that reminds you of, don't it?
Very happy. But that year, he would face a crisis. One bright, sunny morning in the summer of that year, Ronald left his house, walked over to his shed. He went inside, and right away, he noticed something. Ronald kept all these bins inside of his shed that were full of all of the different tools that he would sell. And because he was in there all the time, either literally selling tools or tinkering with whatever it was he was building himself, he was very aware of how full each of these bins were. And anytime they got low, he would order more so he had enough supply to sell. And so he went into his shed this morning and he noticed right away that a couple of the bins appeared to be a little bit lower than he remembered. And
this is scary. Bunch of y'all have that ability. Like, Queen, for me, has that ability. Like, when she could walk out of her office, like, and she has so much stuff in her office, but she could walk out of her office and know when she comes back if something is moved or something's not right. You know what I mean? I be doing so much that, man, you can come in here and probably remove this whole couch over here.
I think, Kathy would not know.
Something ain't right. Something's missing. And I still won't figure it out. Snap, the couch is gone. You know what I'm saying? Some of y'all got that gift and ability.
Right away, that a couple of the bins appeared to be a little bit lower than he remembered. And right away, Ronald is thinking, you know, did I forget to order supplies to fill these bins up? Did I just forget to do that? But he's thinking to himself, you know, I am meticulous in making sure my inventory is full at all times. I've been doing this for decades, and so it can't be me. You know, maybe I took the tools and I brought them into my house and I've left them in there, or maybe they're in my truck. And so Ronald, believing there's a totally logical explanation for this, would leave his shed and he would search his property, but he can't find these tools anywhere. And so he began calling his family and his friends to see if, you know, maybe they had come by and borrowed some of these tools, or maybe they knew what had happened to them. But everyone he spoke to said, no, I have no idea. And so by that afternoon, Ronald had found himself back inside of his work shed, looking around, thinking to himself, have I been robbed? It was the only logical thing he could think of that would explain this loss. And so Ronald drove to the police station and he spoke to police and he explained what happened. But unfortunately, the police's reaction to what he was telling them was not exactly what he wanted. They basically assumed that, you know, he just had miscounted. That
looking at him probably like he was old, you know, this older guy, what he said, was like 65. He's starting to, you know what I mean? His memory's starting to go on him a little bit. That's how they'll start to look at you, bro.
Exactly what he wanted. They basically assumed that, you know, he just had miscounted, that in reality the tools were either still in the shed and he just forgot how many were supposed to be in there, or he had just kind of lost them on his property somewhere, that they were bound to turn up. And so the police told him, look, Ronald, go back and search your property. I'm sure they're there. And if you get some proof that someone actually stole from you, then come back to us. And so Ronald was really annoyed by this. He wanted them to take this seriously, but he could tell they just were not going to. So Ronald drove back to his house, he went inside, hopped on his computer, and he began researching what other homeowners did to protect themselves from things like theft. And one of the things he came across was setting up tripwires all around the perimeter of your property. Basically, you take these thin wires.
Yo, wait a minute, bro. We skipped cameras. Tripwire, that was the first thing you stopped at? Like, I don't think he was gonna say, you know, I get a couple cameras.
Thumbs up.
So he went out and he set up tripwires all around his property. But over the next several days, after these wires were stood up, none of the wires made any sound, and still more tools continued to go missing. This was also in spite of the fact that his shed was locked at night. And so Ronald's thinking to himself, whoever's doing this is clearly watching me and kind of monitoring what I'm doing. They must be aware of the tripwires, and they must be sneaking into the shed, you know, at some time that I have the doors unlocked. I mean, this is a professional thief. And so as Ronald is thinking about this master thief that is targeting him, he has this subtle fear that if he can't stop this person from breaking into his shed and taking his tools, how can he possibly protect himself against this person breaking into his home and stealing things from him there, which included all of his cash and many other valuables? And so Ronald became very fearful and decided the only thing he could do was really beef up his home security system. And so he hopped back online and he began Googling other ways to protect your property. And after discovering a number of really effective techniques, he got to work. He began building all these home defense systems and placing them all around his property. And after all of these kind of DIY security measures were put up, the theft of his tools stopped. And in Ronald's mind, that validated that his defense system had worked. He was effectively preventing theft. But this would not be the end of his troubles. Fast forward to Thanksgiving that year, so November 28th, and the Van Buren police got a very frantic phone call from Ronald. He was totally hysterical. He wasn't really making sense. And the police, they tried to understand what was going on, but all they could get from Ronald was that he was requesting police to come to his residence immediately. And so the police, they hang up, and they're thinking, okay, you know, we know Ronald was dealing with a potential thief. Maybe he literally caught the thief red-handed, and he wants us to come and arrest this person. And who knows, maybe they're fighting at his residence right now. And so the police speed over to Ronald's house. They pull into his driveway, and at first glance, nothing looks out of the ordinary. Ronald's truck is in the driveway, and there's no obvious signs of a disturbance, but they notice the front door to Ronald's house is wide open. And so the police park their cars in Ronald's driveway, they get out and they run up onto the front porch, and they're standing in front of this open door, and they look down, and they can see there's a very obvious blood trail starting from the front of Ronald's house, going straight back down a hallway that looped around to the left and out of sight. And so right away, the police are yelling into the house, "Ronald, Ronald, are you okay? What's going on?" And somewhere deep inside of the house, they hear what sounds like Ronald make a kind of guttural sound. So immediately this tips the police that more than likely Ronald has been hurt, and he likely is the one who made this blood trail. And so the police draw their guns and they go inside of Ronald's house, not really sure what they're going to find. They don't know if there's some intruder or attacker or someone in here that's harmed Ronald, but they make their way down this hall following the blood trail. They turn the corner, and then sitting at the end of the blood trail is Ronald. He's sitting down with his back to some cabinets in the kitchen, and he's clutching his midsection. He is covered in blood. He's completely pale. And so right away, the officers call in backup. But then as a security measure, they search the rest of the first floor to make sure there is no other person here. There was no one on the first floor. They went to the second floor. They peeked around up there. They didn't see anyone. So they rushed back down to Ronald, who's still just sitting there, and they begin administering first aid.
Is it Ronald? Like, I'm starting to think it's him now.
I remember the story actually on the news, so I have an advantage here.
What happened? How did you get hurt? But Ronald is clearly in shock. He's kind of in a daze. He's not making sense. And then by the time the paramedics showed up, just a couple of minutes later, Ronald had slipped into unconsciousness. When Ronald was wheeled out of the house, the responding officers and the backup officers, who by now had arrived, decided to search the rest of Ronald's house to see if there was some clue as to what had happened. And so they began searching in the kitchen, looking around, but there wasn't anything that stood out to them. And then they began walking around towards the living room. And when they got into the living room, one of the officers suddenly screamed to everyone inside to stop where they were, stop moving. It would turn out Ronald, as part of his very beefed up home security system, had installed various booby traps all around his property, including inside of his house. And some of these traps were gun booby traps. The officer that had yelled for everyone to stop had spotted one of these traps. He saw a handgun anchored to the ceiling aimed at the front door, and there was a string attached to the trigger that was also then attached to the doorknob of the front door.
He just stepped into a soft scene.
Oh yeah, you know he did.
One with the gun
you, babe.
Did somebody have their face off?
It was a mess.
Just got to realize
it really
situation.
Was.
Bro, yo, what's wrong
yeah,
with
put
bro?
Put them in some water. They'll stay for
he
a little while.
He was not playing about his tools, fam.
A string attached to the trigger
man,
that was also
I tell
then attached
you.
To the doorknob of the front door. And so if this trap were live and some
oh.
person opened the front door, it would activate this trap, causing the gun to shoot them. And so clearly, Ronald had accidentally left this particular booby trap on, and he had accidentally activated it, shooting himself. And so after the officer sees this gun anchored to the ceiling, he tells everyone, and they begin looking up and just looking around to see if there are other traps. And amazingly, there are. In other doorways, just from where they're standing, they can see the barrels of guns pointing down that are obvious booby traps. In their haste to get in there and figure out what was going on, they hadn't noticed all of these guns in the ceiling, and so it was just kind of a miracle that none of the other traps had been set off.
They got lucky.
Would be rushed to the hospital that night, but he would pass away from his wound. His death would be ruled an accident, and to this day, we don't know if he really was dealing with a professional thief that was stealing his tools, or if it was just a figment of his imagination.
Ronald was determined to the fact. You know what I mean? You gotta be mindful though. You set all this stuff up. You gotta remember where you got all this stuff. You can't wake up in the middle of the night.
Either that or just not set it up.
Mess around and hit a trip wire. That's good night, Irene. Yo, Ronald was crazy.
Well, I'm gonna go ahead and stop the video there. Please check out the Matthew fam. Be a part of the Matthew gang and enjoy the videos like I have with him. They have another channel too, Just the Tip. Yeah, that's one where him and Queen actually do video together. Me and Kathy, we love watching that together. By the way, Queen, come on, keep doing more videos. You're just as good as him on that screen. L, again. Thank you so much for all the videos you put out there. Mr. Baldwin, Slapped Ham, and the rest of them. Oh, just awesome channels. Please check them out. And again, my hat's off to you, the Matthew fam. L, Queen, from the bottom of my heart, thank you for all the time you put into everything. Mr. Baldwin, same, and the rest. Remember, everybody, also, I know things are hard right now at times, you know. We all have it hard. But please remember places like St. Jude's. Go to stjudes.com/donate. And make sure you, if you can, give a dollar or two. Help out those kids that are fighting cancer, those family members that are fighting cancer. Remember, they're out there. No matter how hard it gets, we all gotta stick together. Help ourselves grow, help the families, you know. Just do what you can if you can. Other than that, you know, if you're on Xbox, check out Ulysses Ace Master. Send him a message about joining Ulysses. Ulysses Angel, Ulysses Blue. Go ahead and message them about joining Ulysses. You can go to Facebook, look up the Ulysses, Flight Squadron page. Go ahead and send a message there about joining. We're more than happy there. They're great people. Well, other than that, I got to say I really did miss you all. Remember, all love to every one of you, man. And you know me. I always gotta do something at least halfway decent and fun, you know? I got a hot sauce here. Has 12 of the hottest peppers in the world, from scorpions, reapers, ghosts, and there's one other kind of pepper. I forget what it was. Dang, I don't remember off the hand. Do you, honey?
Peach scorpion, I think.
No, that was one of them, the other pepper. There's scorpion, ghost, reaper, and there was one other one.
Chocolate reaper.
No, that's the flavor of it.
Oh, I don't remember.
There was another type of pepper.
I don't remember.
I don't remember either. All I know is, yeah, there's peach, there's the regular, there's the chocolate in here. Oof, of every one of them. Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. This is some good stuff. And to the people I was going to mail this to, if you send me a message on the Xbox or on Facebook, send me, you know, hey, send me a bottle of your hot sauce, go ahead and do that. Just send me a message, DarknessXPHK, go ahead and send a message there on Xbox, or either that, or you can message me on Facebook by going to Shane DeYoung on Facebook. Look for, I believe it's the picture of the flower with the background of old booba juice still from when I did my walk for Make-A-Wish and Children in Need. Well, yeah. You know, I just can't do normal. I just don't do normal. They say it burns the skin. I don't believe them. I gotta find out, you know? Other than that, I'd like to say I love you all. And remember, old Pothead Kenny loved you. Yepper!